Are we gonna make it? We're so close, and but there's no juice left. We are 3% battery.
Hello everyone. Today we're sitting in the new Model 3 and we are on the road again. We are traveling to Vienna and we want to record a video for you guys showing what's the efficiency of the battery, how far we can go with it, and also how fast does it charge. So we just started our journey. We were on 100%. Right now we are 92. We are recording the trip. We've been driving already 23 kilometers and we want to see how far we can go with it. One more thing we want to try is to show you how fast does the new battery charges. As you know, we are on the standard range model, which has the LFP battery, which can be charged up to 100% without damaging the battery itself. So we want to see how long that's going to take. All right, we are on the road still. Been driving for 74 kilometers. We have 78% left, which equals 326 kilometers. We will see how far we're actually gonna go. We added our first supercharging destination, which should allow us to arrive on about 16%. Still on the road, traveling to our first stop of our journey, and we are on 51% charge, which equals to about 215 kilometers. We've been traveling for 150 as well, which means we should drive it up to 300 kilometers only, which is a very, very poor range. But I want to open a break here that we are in Germany, so time to time we're driving with no speed limit. We even push the car up to 203 kilometers, which is the top speed, just to test it out. So it's not the most accurate test, but in the video we're also gonna show how it's gonna perform when we are driving in a constant speed of about 120 or 130 kilometers without any rapid acceleration. Still on the road. We just got a notification that the battery starts to precondition, even though we're on 38% and we are on about 38 minutes away from the supercharger. 38% equivalent to about 160 kilometer by Tesla's calculations. And honestly, the battery is pretty warm already. Our application states that it's on about 35 degrees Celsius, which is pretty good. And we have about 38 minutes to see how higher it's gonna get and how fast the first initial few minutes of charging will be. And finally, we just stepped on a Autobahn, a place where everybody knows what this sign means. Let's test how fast the new Model 3 will accelerate to 200 kilometers per hour, which should be about its top limit speed. And have in mind that we are on 33% charge, so don't expect much. Welcome to Germany. Exactly how it's advertised, 203 kilometer top speed. A quick update, guys. We had to change our supercharging location to another city because even though the Tesla was telling us that we're gonna arrive under 20% charge, the car is very efficient and right when we got to the supercharging station, we saw that the percentage was about 21, so we think it's too high. We wanted to drain it a little bit more, and trust us, we step on the accelerator a lot because we're in Germany, as you saw in the previous video. And yeah, just the battery doesn't drain so fast, so that's why we are going to another city, try another location with a 250 kilowatt stalls, just because we want to make sure that the battery is going to be under 8% of charge. And one more thing we noticed after we change our location for the supercharging, we actually saw that the preconditioning of the battery stopped. For some reason, the car decided that the battery is hot enough, but it's only on 39 degrees. Remember, about 40 minutes ago when we started the preconditioning cycle, the battery is on about 34, 35 degrees, so it ramped up only by about 5 degrees, and now it's not warming up anymore. Not sure if that's the case with the LFP battery. We're gonna take a look at it, and we're gonna see later on if we can manually precondition it up to a higher degree. We're arriving at our first supercharger destination at about 5%. Guys, we try to drain it a lot. We press on the pedal to the metal. We drove with a 203 kilometers per hour for quite a bit. Just this battery doesn't die. We've done about 303 kilometers, which is not the best range. Of course, Tesla states that it should go around 500 kilometers. However, we were not going for efficiency this round. We were just trying to drain it as quick as possible so we can do the test. An interesting fact, like we mentioned in the previous video, that the battery stopped preconditioning. Look, it dropped to down to 38.5 degrees. This is the LFP battery. We are not too knowledgeable if this is the max degree Celsius that it can get to, but let's see after we plug in what's the top speed we're gonna get. As you can see, we are totally alone on these stations. We're not sharing the juice with anybody. You're gonna plug in immediately. The supercharger is a V3 and we're supposed to get 250 kilowatts. Let's see what's the maximum charge speed we're gonna get. All right, we have a connection. It's ramping up. Come on, keep going, keep going, keep going. Nice. Remember, the top speed this car is offering is 170 kilowatts. It took literally 10 seconds, which is pretty sweet. So I guess this vehicle can start fast charging even under 40 degrees Celsius temperature, which is pretty sweet. Tomorrow we're gonna do a new test where we're gonna see, try to charge the car immediately after we get it from the parking lot, which then the battery should be under 20 degrees Celsius, and we'll see how fast it's gonna start charging. We're gonna spend some time here. We're gonna charge up to the limit of 100%, see how fast that's gonna be. It states it's gonna take 40 minutes. Right now it's 11:40, but let's see. We've been standing and charging for about 10 minutes now, and the car is already on 45%, which is, we charged 40% in about 10 minutes. The kilowatts dropped down to 97, which is not the best, but it's still great. 40% in 10 minutes, in my opinion, that's pretty fast charging. We are almost done charging. We are at 81%. The speed is already 44 kilowatts, which is not the best. But just for the sake of the video, we're gonna stay all the way until 100% just to see how much time it's gonna take. But this is the stats from our trip so far. So from the last charge, we had 303 kilometers went, and the watt hour per kilometer, as you can see down here, are 176. Dimitar, the person who was driving this vehicle, drives slightly more aggressive. Of course, we're in Germany, we can afford that. However, me now, I'm gonna drive safer, a little bit more efficient. I'm not gonna press on the accelerator that much, and we're actually gonna see what's gonna be the actual range test when you drive this car more efficiently. And we got to 99% state of charge. We are waiting for the last couple kilowatts to go into the battery. We wanna see exactly how long it's gonna take to charge fully from 5% to 99%. The car initially was saying that it's gonna take about 40 minutes, but unfortunately we've been staying here for already an hour. We're not sure if that's the case because the car is calibrating. Again, this is a brand new model. We've been driving it for like 1,000 kilometers only, or just the calculations are not precise yet. We're gonna see, we're gonna test it for you guys, and we're gonna let you know with every video from now on. But yeah, we've been staying here for 1 hour. We are getting only about 3 kilowatts into the battery. Hopefully we're gonna be done soon. And finally, we are on 100%. Let's go unplug. Like I said, I'm gonna be the one driving this time. Try to do a little more efficiency test. And let me see, Dimitar, what's the temperature of the battery currently? When we arrived, we were at, I believe, 38.5 degrees. And right now, we are at 45 degrees. All right, let's see what's gonna be the temperature when we arrive on our next stop. We have already entered it. It's gonna be a supercharger right between Vienna and Germany. We're gonna arrive there at 16%, but let's see if that's the case. We are off the highway. We are driving on small German roads between different villages, and we're still on 100%. The road is not as smooth, and our average speed is about 60 to 70 kilometers. Finally, after about 57 kilometers through different villages in Germany, we are on the Autobahn. Like you can see, there is no speed limit anymore. However, like I promised, it's gonna be an efficiency test, so I'm not gonna go above 130 kilometers, which should be about 75 miles or so. So let's see how much battery we're gonna use until we get to our next destination, which is gonna be in about 242 kilometers or 2.5 hours. Well, just like in every test, there are some unpredictable things, and traffic is one of them. We are on a German highway without any speed limit, and we are driving with 5 kilometers an hour. Also, one thing I wanna mention is that throughout the whole test, we are using the AC in a split form, just as a normal user would. We are not trying to save any extra energy. Again, this is a real life experience, just like everybody's gonna be doing it. And just like the last time, the car lied to us, but in a good way. It was stating that we're gonna arrive to the supercharger at around 16%. Guys, hear me out. When we started driving, it was saying that we're gonna arrive there at 16%, and in about, I don't know, like 35% state of charge lost, it changed to 26%, so it increased. So for us, that's, you know, not an ideal situation, because we want to travel more, get more the most out of the battery. So we changed the location with another supercharger station, which is about 75 kilometers further away, and now it says that we're gonna arrive at 2%. Is this true? Is it not? I don't know. All right, we are cutting it really, really, really close. We have 24% battery. It's already dark and it's raining outside. We've been driving for 314 kilometers so far, and we still have 93 kilometers to go. Honestly, I'm not confident enough that we're gonna make it there. So cross your fingers. I really wanna see that we're gonna pass 400 kilometer mark. It's still not gonna be the same as Tesla says that this car can do. It says that we can do about 513 kilometers. But still, 400 for a standard range model with an LFP battery, that's plenty for most people. Are we gonna make it? We're so close, but there's no juice left. We are 3%
battery. There is still 11 minutes to travel, 11 kilometers to go. And one interesting thing, we've been navigating to a supercharger for over 3 hours, and I was expecting for the car to start preconditioning the battery, but it did not. It stays on about between 32 and 34 degrees Celsius constantly, which I assume that this is the maximum that the battery needs to be so it can fast charge. We'll see. We're not experts like Kyle from Out of Spec. He knows everything about batteries that a person can know. But guys, we're cutting super close. 3% battery left, 10 kilometers to go. Oh shit, just like Bjorn says it, we're already at 0% battery left, and we've been driving like this for the past 3 minutes or so. The good part is Tesla always have some buffer, some extra energy that it's not calculated in these percentages. You can see it inside our application. It still says that we have 2.7% buffer left inside the battery, which means there's going to be plenty of juice for us to come to the supercharging station, which should be somewhere around here. I don't see it though. Where is the supercharger? There you go. We saw it. Nice. We just made it on time. Let's see what the stats are and how much actually energy we used and how many kilometers we've traveled on a full charge. So we made it, we're right on time, and bam, we came with 0% juice left. We were not worried, we were just playing because we knew that we have enough energy just because of our sexy app. Like you can see, the two most important things for us are how much actually remaining battery we have, and as you can see, there's 2.6 kilowatts remaining, even though the car says that they are zero. And the second most important thing is how many degrees is the battery, so am I good to fast charge, something that's important for everybody just to not to waste extra time. Let's see how many kilometers we passed. So we've been driving all day, we went 410 kilometers on a full charge with an average speed of about 120 kilometers per hour, which is about 68, 70 miles per hour top speed. We've been driving mainly on autopilot, and the weather was pretty okay, raining time to time, a little traffic here and there, and we always used the heaters. Let's plug in. Let's see how fast we're gonna start charging. We're not gonna stay here for too long because we only need to get to our hotel. Let's see how fast the handshake is gonna be. Come on Tesla, you're the best. What's happening? Is this one broken? Bam, we're done. Let's go now. 22? Always expecting more. Come on, faster, faster, faster. Are we gonna get those 170? Keep climbing, keep climbing. No freaking way. 116. Well, I guess that's it. We are actually not sure, is that the V2 or V3 charging station? It's the first time here, but it's probably V2. 116, that's very disappointing. And the most important thing is that we got here, the Tesla Model 3 Highland is amazing. The range is insane, over 400 kilometers in one charge with the standard range LFP battery. It cannot get any better. All right, thank you so much guys for watching. In the next video, we're gonna show you the acceleration and the performance of the motors, or the motor, it's only one. So see you next time.